Hi, good morning, church. This is a beautiful, precious day for us, and because the Lord has given to us, and no matter what the challenges today, no matter what the things are waiting for us, but we know that God is with us. And I just wanted to today just to thinking about the two incidents in Moses' life after he became the chosen leader. And leading the people from Egypt to the promised land, and they came just this is just they came out of that Egypt, and they are on the way. In Exodus chapter 14, they faced a big challenge of the Red Sea, and behind is an Egyptian army. And Moses, like was like the people are crying, and Moses in a really in a challenging situations. And though he said God will fight, but then he brought that request before God in Exodus chapter 14. In Exodus chapter 17, and God brought them that place in a powerful way. And in Exodus chapter 17, and these people are in the wilderness. Now they are 3 months in the wilderness, and they are moving slowly. And it is a terrible wilderness. There's no water, there's no amount, like there's no food. These things are like, but now God graciously I heard their request. And these people are like, these people of Israel are rebelled. The people of Israel is just to going against the God and the nature, but still God graciously patiently provide what these people need. And in Exodus chapter 17, and again there is a really challenging. Moses is in between people and the challenge, and the people said, why you brought us? There's no water. And Moses cried out to the Lord, and God told him, come to this Mount Horeb, and there is a rock, and I'm going to you command, and you are just to strike the rock, the water will come out. And exactly that happened. And now they will be in that near that mountain and for months, and then you see this challenge like happens in our life, whether you are a missionary, whether you are a pastor, whether you are a layman or a woman, we all face the challenge. We all feel that pressure. But the issue is that where that pressure is lying. And this is very crucial in our life. Is it lying inside of me? Am I carrying that, or am I putting that pressure before God in the right place? This is so, like if Moses' life was exemplary in this area. And for us, as we are facing in this challenging times, and Hudson Taylor, like in his secrets of like the Hudson Taylor book, and the spiritual secrets of Hudson Taylor, in that book he says this, like there was a challenging situations came when he was in China, and there was a riot happened, Yangchuk, and there was a riot happened, and he could not support his people, and he was willing to cut down the comforts which they were doing. He was saying that I can cut down the things on the food which where I can get cheaper than what I getting right now. But he says like this, to diminish one's comfort, it is very small thing for me. Diminishing one's comfort, meaning I can cut down the comforts. It's not a big challenging. But diminishing the work of God, I can't do that. We can't do that. Okay? Because we cannot reduce the work of God. We have to go forward. And he was facing this amazing challenge of how to just go forward because of the riot happening outside. And there is an inside. There is a cause of a concern how to provide. It's like a Moses. But in the story, he says that it doesn't matter really how great the pressure is. He says this. It doesn't matter how great the pressure is. It only matters the where the pressure lies. See that it never comes in between you and God. Because when the pressure comes between me and God, what happens? And it all, I'm thinking, I'm just looking at that pressure, and I can't and enjoy the presence of God. As David says, Psalm 16, I have set the Lord always before me. Because he is at my right hand, I will not be moved. So in this, Hudson Taylor says that, see that it never comes between you and God. But the greater the pressure, the more it presses you to the breast of our Lord. And that's amazing. The greater the pressure, let it presses towards the Lord. And it's amazing that story says that, like when that everything was closed. But then God has moved George Mueller. I think George Mueller, like, and he was moved in England to support the China Inland Mission. Everything was closed. All the provision was closed. But then George Mueller, like God provided the Hudson Taylor and his whole team. That supply through George Mueller, another man of God. This is amazing that he says, like, he was like a challenging time and not having joy, and the spiritual joy was hindered, spiritual rest was hindered. But praise be to God. Today, I don't know what troubles you today, but there is an amazing hope. There is a balm in Gilead. You are hurt, there is a balm in Gilead which can heal us. You are crushed under the burden. And you think it's nothing, but Jesus says that, come to me, all you heavy laden, come to me, and I will give you rest. Matthew chapter 11, 28. And you can believe what the Savior says, you can believe, or you can believe what your past says. Believe what the Savior says, believe what the Bible says. Come to him, run to him, and you will be never, never be disappointed. May God bless this morning, in Jesus' name.